In this video, I want to take you through introduction to SW maps on PC or laptop. In the previous video, I've shown you how to install SW maps on your computer. So today I want to show you the interface of SW maps on laptop or computer. So once you have installed it, you can watch the video, it's in the description box. Just double click to launch the application. When you open it, this is the first prompt it brings. Click on open projects, click on new projects. Then we can just name it tutorial and click on create. So we can now maximize this. So you can see the name of the project tutorial. So you can see the interface of SW maps on laptop or PC. So here you can see the menu icon. If you click on it, it will bring all the menu of SW maps just as it used to display in Android. So when you open SW Maps for the first time, the default location is Nepal. So you can click on this icon to take you to your current location. For instance, if I click on it, it has taken me to my current locations. And more essentially, you can change your background map. To change background map, can come to layer. So you can see background map. The current background map is Google Terrain. If you click on this drop down, you can change it to Google Hybrid. You can see it has changed to Google Hybrid. You can close this. If you want to open previous projects, click on this icon. You can see the project. If I had other projects, I'll see the project here. And if I want to create another project, I'll click on this plus icon to open another project. Let's close this. More importantly, you can zoom in and zoom out by scrolling your mouse. Then if you come back to this menu icon, you can see the project settings. You can see project attributes. And you can zoom to extent of your project here, and here if you go down, you can see the sky plots, and you can see the GNSS status. So you can see the number of satellites you are connected to, and here you can see feature, you can see track, and you can also take snap picture. And here you can import projects. You can import templates and you can import CSV. Here, after you are done with your project, you can share your project. For instance, if I click on share, I can share it as project, I can share it as KMZ or shapefile or even JSON. You can share it as CSV or spreadsheet or even GeoPackage. So this software is actually very rich in data collections. So I've done previous video on this using Android. So I'm just showing you the interface of the software on computer. So you can use it on Android and you can also use it on computer, though it's more flexible or more portable in Android than on computer. So you can use this to search and you can use this to zoom to your locations. So you can use this icon to take photograph or picture. Thank you for watching.